Well, welcome back to the 700 Club. It's time for your email questions. We call it Bring It On, so we're going to bring it on right now with Eric, who writes in and says, I have always loved to tell jokes, and someone told me that there are actually some physical benefits to laughing. Yes. Can a sense of humor really make a difference in your health?
There's no question. The Bible says a merry heart doeth good like medicine, and it really does keep you healthy. Mm-hmm. You breathe in more, your blood pressure goes down, your whole physiognomy is improved with laughter. You know, an average child, you know, when he gets to be, you know, a couple years old or 3 or 4 years old, he laughs 400 times a day. Mm-hmm. Little kids laugh all the time.
They do, and they giggle. And I tell you, that's one of my favorite sounds in the world is a little baby giggling.
Yeah.
Or a little baby laughing. My favorite sound.
Well, but we suppress that. You got to, you know, be quiet. You can't. Mm-hmm. But having a good time is really of the Lord. And yes, it's healthy.
This woman once told me, she goes, you laugh too much. I said, how do I laugh too much? She's like, you laugh too much. Is it real? I'm like, how do you fake a laugh?
Yeah.
You know, but it's just...
That's why you're gonna live to 110.
I'm going to live a long time.
Long time.
Yeah.
All right.
Long as you don't harass me.
Oh, how could I do that?
All right, Serena
All
says,
right, what?
My 8-year-old son loves soccer and has been on a team since he was little. I see a lot of other parents pushing their kids to be competitive. Should I encourage him to be more serious and work harder, or just let him have fun and get some exercise?
Honey, let the child have fun.
Mm-hmm.
These people, these little league parents that go nuts with them, you know, 8 or 9 year old, you know, misses a ball and everything, scream and yell. No way, let them enjoy it.
Exactly.
It's a game.
Exactly. Exactly. And here's another thing, too.
What?
As a parent, I don't feel like we have to put our child in every sport at one time.
That's right.
And you know what I mean? It's kind of like, just let them go outside and play ball. Why do they have to be a part of soccer and hockey
get
and basketball?
Get them outside.
Yeah, get them outside. That's true.
Right. If you have to throw the ball with them. All right.
That's true. Wayne says, in the past year, our family has gone through a lot of life changes, like moving across the country, changing jobs, and dealing with some major health issues. I know that we need to get rid of some of the stress in our lives, but I'm not sure how. Do you have any suggestions for stress busting?
Prayer, meditation, the biggest thing is roll your cares over on the Lord. If you keep the cares, the other thing is forgive. Wherever you are, forgive. Just don't harbor grudges. Do not harbor grudges. I mean, that'll eat you up. So, you know, and just relax. I mean, hey, it's only money. It's only a game. It's only a little bit of life. And then you're going to go to be with the Lord for eternity. So get your priorities right and get settled what you're going to do with Jesus. And once you're contented with Him and your life is right with Him, all this other stuff's going to take care of itself. And if you carry the burdens, you're making a big mistake. Take your burdens to the Lord, the song used to say, and leave them there. All right.
That was good, brother. Look at you. Very good.
Let's go.
Okay. Elena writes in and says, I know they just told me this. What is SAMI? I don't know. Yeah. My doctor prescribed it for me for joint pain as well as depression. The SAM and then E seems to be helping me, but I don't know how much about. I don't know very much about it. And can you tell me about it?
Something a lot of us don't know much about.
Yeah,
but it's made with two natural ingredients. ADP is found in all your cells, and it's an energy source. And this stuff will release, as I understand, several important chemicals to make you feel good. You know, it's like the feel-good response that you get from running, you know. It is very good for arthritis. It is good for pain relief, and it's a natural thing. So
I never even heard of it before.
Well, it's a lot of things we haven't heard about, and that's one of them.
Okay, cool. All right, here's one from Daniel who says, I need help to get energized in the morning, but my doctor has taken me off of coffee and caffeine. Do you know any strategies for me to be more alert, not only in the morning, but throughout the day?
Dolly Parton, that song, I pour myself a cup of ambition. You know?
I know, working 9 to 5. Yeah. That's right.
Anyhow, you need a cup of ambition. I don't know what you do. You can find various warm drinks that'll give you a little bit of a boost that are not caffeinated. They're things that you can get, health drinks with various herbal preparations. The biggest thing is stay away from sweets. Don't load up before you go to bed at night with a lot of heavy food. Eat a very light meal at night. Don't load up with a lot of beef a lot of gravy, a lot of sweets. Stay away from that stuff because that'll drag you down. It'll make you feel draggy. So, and get yourself some protein bars. Go to the health food store and tell them you want a low-carb protein bar, and they've got scores of those things. Everybody's got boxes of those bars, so you can eat one of them along the way, and you'll feel better. But you need to, the thing that makes people buzz is that you've got something important to do in life, and that activates you.
Mm-hmm. Right? That's true. And for me, it really is. It's about a balance of food, a balance of sleep, and a balance of exercise. Because you ever notice that when you exercise consistently, you sleep really well, and then you wake up and you feel good?
A lot better.
Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Okay, Jessica writes in and says, my husband and I want to eat healthier meals, but the price of fresh produce and meats actually seem to drive up the cost of our grocery bill. Do you have any tips for being healthy as well as frugal shopper?
Well, you can buy quantity of things. One of the things, you know, if you can have fresh markets, sometimes you can buy quantities of vegetables and can them. That may be a little bit old-fashioned, but you can put up your own vegetables. The other thing is, get those coupons. You know, every newspaper on, I think, Thursday will have grocery coupons. Mm-hmm. Clip them and use them. That you can save an enormous amount of money using those coupons. And then with your grocery budget, don't spend a lot of money on junk food,
the
empty calories, and concentrate on the areas in your grocery that have fresh vegetables and fresh fruit. And again, work away where you cook only those things you want to eat, or you can try to can or preserve something. Okay.
You know what I do?
What's that?
Frozen. I buy a lot of frozen food because frozen tends to be a little bit cheaper, less expensive.
You
save money because it doesn't go bad as quick. And so I do everything from frozen fish. Sometimes, as soon as I get my chicken, I put it instantly into the freezer. My vegetables I buy frozen, even my fruit from frozen strawberries and things of that sort. I buy those in frozen bags because, one, if you keep them in the refrigerator, especially if they're off-season, they go rotten quicker.
That's right.
And number two, a lot of times we eat, you know, fruit for a smoothie or what have you. So frozen, frozen, frozen. And it's, you know, your food, your grocery bill is like any other budget. So you cut down other things that you don't really need. Do you really need those, you know, crackers with cheese in them? Or will this work?
Excellent advice. Excellent.
Well, you know, I'm trying, Pat.
I'm proud of you. That's good. All right,
here's one. Okay, really quick from Marion. Do we have time for one more, Sandy?
Yeah, sure.
We don't? Yeah? Yeah, we're going to try. Okay. It seems to me that every couple years, someone comes out with a study saying something is healthy. And a few years later, there's another study that says it isn't. That's so true. Why can't the researchers make up their mind?
Because there's so many people out there looking to get on television and looking to put out something in the press. And the question is, was this a double-blind study? Was it something that was done under the auspices of respected scientists?
Mm-hmm.
Or is it some guy working in a garage who comes up with a theory?
Exactly.
You've got to find out what the source is of these things.
Mm-hmm.
But that's, I mean, it's just one of those things. There's so many of them. So do your own research and get your research from respected figures who know what they're talking about.
Exactly.
All right.
Like us.
Like,
I don't know.
Yeah.
Just kidding. All right. If you want to ask Pat more questions, just log on to CBN.com with Bring It On. And he loves to answer them.